senior or a family that has to deal with their senior can list, have an agent list and sell the house.
Yes.
Period. What do you do with 40 years of accumulation? What do you do with everything in there? I mean, I've done everything from placing a person's dog to helping someone get into a new place, into a retirement home, where even the toothbrush was set out for them. They did nothing. I had someone actually go away for a week. We looked after all the decluttering, everything done, and got them moved in. And they weren't there for the process because we knew they were too distraught to handle
it. Someone is in their late 60s, early 70s, there's no reason they can't live another 30 years. Mm-hmm. That's an awful lot of money at $5,000 a month.
If you're listening to this anywhere in the Golden Horseshoe of Ontario, you're looking at extremely high expenses per month to put mom and dad into a fine place. Mm-hmm. And there's a difference between warehousing an adult, a senior, and giving them a quality of life. Unfortunately, I've had clients that have sold their houses and ran out of money. Millennials, some of them will live to be 120. Well, there's two levels. First of all, you have to be a master, you have to become an ASA. And to become an ASA member, it's really somebody that's, you don't work with seniors just because it's another box to check off, another segment of the market. You work with seniors because you actually like to. You do it because you care. Moving people and changing their lifestyle.
Yes.
So this is emotional. And you know what? The satisfaction level is phenomenal. To be a master accredited senior agent means you take the accredited senior agent program plus another three, four, I think up to five different courses. You got mandatory education all through the year. We have all kinds of meetups and group stuff and sessions and education. And you know, and because most of us that are in it, this is the largest part of our business is dealing with the senior market. Not well, seniors market, senior market.
Some of us in the accredited senior agent program, especially in the masters, at least five of us took another program called Essential Conversations.
We are trained to deal with exactly your situation.
We sit down with the families and we have the essential conversation.
Mm-hmm. Look at the taboos in a family. Let's talk about taboos.
Okay.
Where am I going to spend the last years of my life? What is going to happen when I pass away? And the biggest taboo of all, let's talk about the money. Let's talk about the money. I've worked a year with a family more than once. Mm-hmm. 9 months, 10 months. Let's just back up for 1 second, if you don't mind.
Nope.
If I come in, you come in as an ASA, let's look at a house, a typical family that's lived in a house 30, 40, 50 years. What's there? You've got sentimental value. We're talking the stuff now, just the stuff. You've got sentimental value, valuable stuff. You've got stuff that if the parent is moving into a retirement home, they've got to take it with them. You've got stuff that could be sold for profit. You've got stuff to be donated, and then you got the junk. Now that's why I bring in a professional consultant that works with them to get to the downsizing. Mm-hmm. So with that said, it's a lot of work. We're there at every aspect, holding their hand, getting rid of, working with them to go through this process. Most realtors won't do that. We could be dealing with, in a lot of cases, we're not dealing with the senior at all. We're dealing with the estate.
Yep.
Or the mom and dad or Aunt Tilly have already gone to a home.
Sounds pretty overwhelming. All
it
the
is
things
over.
That, it, I know. It I know is. It is.
The word easy is not applicable. But as a master ASA, you ease the process. You make it, you walk in. It is such a relief when I walk in, I see families, I start explaining what can be done, how to take pressure off, and they look at each other and it's almost like a sigh and they go, oh, thank God, somebody's got control. We can relinquish some of this. Because you've got people in frenzies, mm-hmm. especially if the siblings don't live in the near mom and dad's house. They gotta come in from distances. We can take that pressure off. Even if we have siblings that love each other, they still have different viewpoints on what to do with mom and dad.
The hardest part, by the way, for the kids, is it's not about mom and dad.
When I say kids, we're talking adults.
Yes.
They have trouble giving up a shrine to their youth. It's their shrine. That was their home.
Their home.
And that's very difficult.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to deal with the loss.
What
one of the
loss?
Biggest problems I have is the dining room set. I can deal with all the stuff. It comes down to a dining room set.
Yes.
I have never seen people hold on to one commodity more than a dining room set. I'm going to tell people right now that are watching this, nobody wants your dining room set. I think I've had more tug and pull over dining room sets than I've had selling the house sometimes.
We have an aging population. I don't know about your area, but in Burlington specifically, the median age is 42. And one third of the Burlington population is aged 55 or older. Mm. So there's a segment of the market that really we need to concentrate on. And I think it's a myth to assume that those people are not online and on social media.
Oh, no, no. There's no question because in my years as an appraiser,
mm-hmm.
I would go into high-rise buildings. And who did you find as a tenant in at 3 o'clock in the afternoon? The seniors. They would be home.
Exactly.
And where were they? Sometimes I saw a husband and wife with two computers back-to-back in their 80 years.
Because
mobility and extended family, because they're using Skype and FaceTime, especially with diverse families all over. They have to keep up. Let's talk about that for a minute. Not all families are the Cleavers from Leave It to Beaver. part of it is family wars. I mean, I've sat down with families that have not spoken to each other in years. I got siblings that hate each other.
Yeah.
They've ended up in courts with each other, but they have to focus on the issue at hand. Thankfully, I've trained to do that.
This is not a comfortable subject, okay? This is the subject of dementia. The parent might see signs that something is happening there, but they're doing their best to hide that from their kid. It hurts. They don't want to see that their parent is having issues. First of all, is for all family members to come to the realization that there's an issue that needs to be dealt with.
Yeah, the elephant in the room.
You brought up dementia. When you've got a woman, and I'm going to give you an example of one that I had, the woman is being forced out of her home by her kids. She leaves the stove on. She hadn't been upstairs in 2-3 years. The house, the cleaning was a disaster. She was dangerous to herself.
What's in the client's best interest? And if there's a safety issue.
There is a safety issue.
If there's a safety
with
issue.
With any Alzheimer's.
Or
a dementia.
Quality of life issue.
Yeah.
Those two things have to be addressed
All
immediately.
Right. So then what happens is, we as realtors, I had this woman that was so angry. She hated her. She was mad as hell at her kids for making her sell the house. She was mad at her lawyer. She was mad at me. And you know what? When it was all over, I smiled. Because in the end, I did the right thing. We did what
right
was
thing.
Best for her. It felt good.
She ended up happy at the end. She really did. Because she was in a better place.
It's so rewarding to see that they're actually happy and they're calling it home.
So I went to visit a client like you did
mm-hmm.
in a retirement home. Beautiful place. And I walk in, I said, "So Jerry, tell me what's it like here?" She says, "It's like going to summer camp when you don't have a baseball team."
I'm really excited because I've enrolled. I believe
yeah.
I was in your very first class.
Colleen, you're coming into the master's program. You're taking this course again, more than once, 3 times, because you care. You've got to understand, the people who are ASA members that are really doing this business, some of the most caring people I've ever seen in real estate. You are one of those people.
Thank you.
I know that when I've spoken to you and you've had a bit of a problem or you've had this, you have always put these clients so ahead of you, and that is the difference. That is what it is all about.
Mm-hmm. Involvement here is greater, and you're going to find the same thing, but the satisfaction level is so much
Thank
nicer.
Thank you very much for taking the time out of your busy schedule to do this, because I really think it's important that we get the message out there and we help people.
I hope my Guelph accent didn't...
It's awesome, Barry.
I hope nobody had trouble with my Guelph accent.
No. And you like to talk with your hands, too. Is that from because you come from
Guelph? I grew up in an Italian neighborhood.